Suspected Thanksgiving murderer was back in court today, fighting to keep some of the evidence against him sealed from the public. Investigative reporter Terry Parker has been poring through the hundreds of pages of evidence released so far. And Terry, you've actually tracked down some of the people cops have investigated in connection with Merhige.
Absolutely, Tiffany. Since a judge agreed to release documents in the case against Paul Michael Merhige, we've gotten a glimpse into his days as a suspected killer on the run. Sifting through those documents, I've now learned that cops were looking to see if anyone was helping Merhige escape capture. Part of their evidence, phone records. Merhige had a total of 5 cell phones when he was caught. I tracked down some of the numbers and the people cops have investigated so far.
As Paul Michael Merhige sits in court, his public defender tries to keep some of the evidence against him out of the public record. But from what has been released so far, we do know this. While the most wanted suspected killer in America was on the lam for several months, he was talking to people on his cell phones. Jupiter detectives subpoenaed all records for a number listed as belonging to Merhige, but when I called it, I reached a man living in Ramrod Key, Wade Laconi, who says he was shocked when cops called him asking about his connection to Merhige.
The cop told me that he had it written down on a piece of paper on him or in his room. And I guess when they investigated who the number belonged to, it came up as my number with my name. And that's why they investigated me. I'm assuming that's why they investigated me. But I don't know him. I've never spoken to him. I've never seen him other than on television.
Another search warrant states Merhige was receiving incoming calls from a cellular phone with a 305 area code. I called the number and reached a man who lives in the Keys and would only reveal his name as Michael. Michael stated he'd had the number for the past 12 years, but denied it was him talking to Merhige while Merhige was hiding in the Keys. His explanation? I don't know him. It's a computer glitch. According to another phone record search warrant, before the murders were committed, the suspect, Paul M. Merhige, utilized his cellular phone to contact his parents, Michael G. Merhige and Carol Merhige. Did the suspect's parents also talk to him after the murders while he was on the run? Those cell phone records have not been released, although agents subpoenaed them. Media attorneys are arguing for the release of all the records.
A Merhige apparently made up the phone number he gave the motel owners of the place where he was hiding until he was caught. And that number belonged to the man you just heard from, Wade Laconi, who says cops investigated and cleared him of any involvement with Merhige. Meantime, the judge in today's hearing is weighing the evidence before deciding whether or not to release any more documents. Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.